So single moms, let's talk about dating single moms. I love single moms. They're a lot of fun to date. They're a lot of fun. You know, they usually, you know, they don't want to, you know, they more know what they want, and they just want to have fun. They, you know, because, you know, a lot of single moms have a lot of responsibilities and duties in their life, so, you know, they just want to have fun. You know, they want someone that can kind of help take their mind off things, and they can be a lot of fun, but something that's important to know if you're, you know, considering about dating single mothers for a, you know, especially if you're considering getting into a long-term relationship with them, is to understand about the situation, the whole. I think it's a lot of times before getting into something like a long-term relationship, because, you know, going through a separation, a romantic separation with someone you're emotionally involved with, can be one of the most devastating things in your life, to take a minute to logically and rationally think the situation through before just jumping into things, just strictly thinking with your emotion or your other head down there. And so that's why I want to fill you in on, you know, some information you want to take into consideration. And that's that, you know, when dating a single mother, you got to understand a couple things. They are fun, and they're usually quicker to jump in the bed and everything. But the thing is that, you know, you're always gonna be a lower priority than their children. They're gonna, you know, their children are always gonna come first before you. And and the thing is that if for some reason if they're not prioritizing their children above you, which isn't always the case. Sometimes I have dated women and seen women that, just basically abandoned their children, just, you know, walked away from the responsibility, let the dad take it away, take care of them. They only see their kid like once every couple of months, and they just let their mom take care of their kids, or their parents take care of their kid for them while they go out and live their best life. Then you got to kind of wonder about the mental health of that woman. You know, if she's willing to just abandon her children and not make her kids the number one priority in her life, then you got to kind of wonder about her mental health. Like, is that somebody that you really want to get, you know, into a long-term relationship with? And then again, if you're getting into a relationship with someone that, you know, knowing that you're always going to be a lower priority than her children, that's again something you got to consider, if that's really someone and that's really something that you can be okay with as the years go on. And now, as you date someone, a single mother, and her kids are around, if they're in her life and everything, then you're going to start to bond and get close with those children as well. And, you know, you may invest financially into them, maybe go out to a, you know, whatever, baseball game with the son, and you buy the tickets, you buy him some toys, and over the years, you buy the kids Christmas presents, and, you know, you get emotionally attached to them. You invest your time and your energy and your emotions into them, and what happens, all of a sudden, you know, you've been dating this person for 5, 10 years, maybe even decades. When it's time to break up, you know, she's gonna, move on with the children out of your life. And most likely, you'll never see those kids again, and you won't have any legal right to see them, because you weren't the biological father of the children. And so, she can just legally take the children right out of your life, and you can never see them again. And I have friends who, had their heart broken because of that, you know, of women that they lived, were single moms, that, they moved in together, and he took care of their children, and her children that she had from a previous marriage and everything. And then all of a sudden, when they split, you know, took the children right out of his life and could never saw them ever again. And that, you know, can be more heartbreaking sometimes, losing that, you know, especially if you've been in the children's life from a very young age. It can be really heartbreaking to have those children just taken right out of your life like that. Because, you know, the mom, and then what's going to happen, can also make it worse, is that, you know, she'll most likely say, you know, all kinds of negative and false things about you to the children to justify, you know, why she left you, why you guys broke up, and you don't ever have a chance to defend yourself, which kind of hurts knowing in the back of your mind that, you know, the last impression that these children have of you, you know, after all the years of investment into them, that, you know, the mom may have filled their head with all kinds of lies and misinformation just to justify, you know, cutting you out of their life completely. And so that can be, you know, really hard. Knowing about that, you know, so that's just some things that you want to consider, you know, if you want to get into a relationship with a single mom. And also something that you got to think about as well, is that, you know, if it's a single mother, that you also, you know, and again, this is, it's one thing, you know, if it's just someone you want to date and have some casual fun with, and but it's another situation when you want to seriously get into a long-term relationship. And another thing you want to think about, you know, is that, you know, if, you know, you got to wonder, you know, all right, unless she's a single mother because, you know, she was widowed or something like that, then you got to wonder, you know, if she did get with the type of guy that was a complete sleazeball and she just got, you know, knocked up from him and then he took off because he was a complete loser and everything, then you got to wonder about her judgment. You know, how poor is her judgment that, you know, she was, you know, so quick to get knocked up by, you know, some complete sleazeball and scumbag. You know, and nobody's perfect. You know, and I'm not saying I've, you know, my life has been all perfect in anything. So, you know, hey, I'm just sharing the situation for what it is. But then, or also the other situation is if it was a good guy that she was with, then you got to wonder, you know, about why, you know, why was she so quick to leave him, you know, if he was a good guy? Or what did she do that drove him so insane that, you know, that he left her if he was, you know, a good guy? So those are just some things that you might want to think about. You know, I know sometimes we just look at the beauty, you know, of a woman and we get mesmerized by it, but we don't really stop and think about, you know, wait a second, why are things the way they are? You know, if she's such a perfect person and the last guy that she was with was this, you know, great, educated, you know, organized, career-driven guy and everything, you know, why did they separate? You know, what is there to that story that I'm not really understanding? And, you know, and if, you know, and if she's willing to replace somebody like that so quickly and, or willing to, you know, walk away from the responsibility of her children, which some women do, which is just mind-boggling that they can just completely walk away from the responsibility of their children, you know, like I said, and just leave it up to, you know, their parents or raising them, or just leave the child with a friend or family or another family completely to raise their own children. Then you got to wonder, like, you know, how quick could this woman be to replace me or to cut me out of her life? If she's willing to do that to her own children, then how quick, I mean, then what do you think she'd be willing to do to you, you know? So just some things to think about. So guys, you know, I know this, the truth can be alarming sometimes, and but this is just, again, red pill awareness. It's not an easy pill to swallow, but the truth will set you free. And most people in this life only think with their emotions, and because of that, it gets them into a lot of trouble. You know, a fool is somebody that goes through their whole life only making decisions based off emotions, and they're just a slave to their emotion, which is most people. Most people in the world are just a slave to their emotions. They don't use any logic or rationale, and again, that's why, you know, the rational male, that's what it's about, being rational and logical, thinking first before just making an emotional decision, because a wise man is one that uses logic and rationale and thinks things through before just, you know, just letting their emotions take the best of them. So, hope you all are having a great day. Keep popping them red pills. Until next time, guys, let's make it a great day, a great week, a great month, a great year. Let's make it a great life. See ya.